Hey, welcome to this Jira Zendesk integration tutorial. My name is Jose, I'm pre-sales engineer at Exalate, and I'll show you how you can integrate these two tools through Exalate integration solution. So what you will be able to see after you have created the connection and integrated these two systems is when you create a ticket either in Zendesk or Jira, that ticket, if it has a specific event that triggers the sync, it will show up on the other end. And then once that ticket is on both ends, you will be able to see the updates that are made from the other end. Those updates can be filtered so that only some of them are seen on the other end. And there's a lot of configuration that can be done. But next, I am going to start with this, with the how to get it, how to create a connection, and then we'll see each feature that is possible with this integration solution. So how do you get Exalate for Jira and Zendesk? You can go to exalate.com, then click on integrations. And then once you have clicked on integrations, you have all the issue trackers that Exalate supports. So for Jira, you'll need to go to the Atlassian marketplace. You have a 30-day trial in which you can synchronize up to 1,000 updates and unlimited fields. And then after that is done, you can either move to a paid subscription or use the basic mode. And the basic mode allows you to sync up to 1,000 updates per month. And you can synchronize the title, description, comments, and attachments. If you want to synchronize fields other than those, then a visual mode or a scripted version is what will work for you. We'll dig deeper into this as we go through the tutorial. For the Zendesk side, you can also click here on Zendesk, and then it'll request your instance URL, and that is how you can access Exalate for Zendesk. So if you're asking, do I need Exalate in both ends? Yes, you'll need to download Exalate in each of the systems that you want to integrate. So I already have Exalate downloaded and configured in each of my systems, in this case, Jira and Zendesk. And what I am going to do is create a connection. So to access Exalate after you have downloaded the product and configured it, you can click on the top right in Jira. In settings, click on apps, and then once you have clicked on apps, you'll have all your add-ons there, and on the left you will see the Exalate tabs. So here they are. I already have it open, so I'm going to close this and go directly to the connection section in Exalate. As you see here, I have multiple connections because with Exalate you can connect to multiple systems, not only Jira Zendesk, but any of the ones that are supported. So GitHub, Azure DevOps, ServiceNow, whatever product we support, you can have them all connected at the same time. And by the way, on the Jira side, you can connect either Jira Cloud, Server, Data Center, and also any of the sub-products like Jira Core, business management, service desk, and any of those that have tickets. So I'm gonna go ahead and create a connection. I'll click initiate connection. Gonna zoom out a little bit here and copy the destination URL, which is the Zendesk URL. So this is the name of the instance that is unique to this Zendesk instance, and I'm gonna paste it here. This verifies that there's an Exalate node on the receiving end, and since there is one, it allows me to continue. And this is what I was talking earlier, in which you have different connection types. If you opt for the basic mode, it is for free forever, so you can synchronize up to four fields. These fields are title, description, comments, and attachments, and you have up to 1,000 syncs that you can do per month. If you are okay with that, then you can have Exalate for free and sync less than those 1,000 updates and only those fields. If you want to use the visual mode, which is a very intuitive UI in which you can select which fields sync from one end to the other. That is with a paid subscription. You have unlimited syncs. You have all the fields that you would like to synchronize here. So that is, that would be a commercial license. That's the one I'm going to use for this video. If you go for the scripted version, it is based on Groovy script, and the unique thing of the scripting version is that it is very flexible. A lot of people like it because they can develop the integration themselves. And then you can also have autonomy between the two instances. So when there is more than one company involved in the integration, these companies usually go for the scripted version because there's no centralized UI. And each company is autonomous from the other one. So each of the systems decides what they send to the other one. And they don't need to have one place for everything. I'm going to go with the visual mode and name this connection. I'll call it video connection. Since I chose the visual mode, this is a centralized UI, so I'll need to verify my admin access on both ends, and after that's done, I can have this centralized UI. And that is why we don't recommend this one for cross-company or multiple companies, because sometimes this is, for security reasons, you don't want a person from another company having control of your data, right? But that's not the case here. Both of the systems are mine, so I'm okay with this. Now, this is where I start configuring the connection. There's already a connection between Jira and Zendesk, and now I am going to select what issues are sent from my Jira to Zendesk. It could also be the other way around, in which we start the synchronization from Zendesk, but in this case, I'm going to keep it from Jira to Zendesk. Here, I select the project that I want to start the synchronization from, and that would be my personal project. In case you're wondering, you can synchronize multiple projects to Zendesk. So this is only for this connection, but you can have another connection or use the scripted version to synchronize more projects. This that I'm selecting, automatic, is in which way do I want to start the synchronization? Do I want to click per ticket every time I want to sync from Jira to Zendesk? Or do I want that to be automatic? And in my case, I want to do that automatically. We can filter which tickets will be sent to Zendesk automatically. So it can be based on a specific label, issue type, status, priority. So I'm going to show you an example. If in this field, priority field, I choose high, then only the issues that have priority high will be sent to Zendesk. If I don't select anything here and I just leave it as it is, it means that any issue that I create from Jira will be sent to Zendesk. That's what I'm going to do for now. I'm going to keep it simple. So I am going to click next. And that's what prompts us to the second tab, which is the rules. These rules are the fields that we are going to update bidirectionally or unidirectionally in this integration. So the labels from Jira will be synchronizing to the tags in Zendesk. Since there's this arrow pointing both ways, it means that this is currently bidirectional. If you want to edit this and you want to maybe sync the labels from Jira to another field other than the tags in Zendesk, you can change that here and just select a different field. So now I would be syncing labels to subject. There's an error there because most probably those fields are not the same type, but you get what I'm saying, right? You can also select which way the information is going. So you can click here and change from to bi-directional to only one way. In this case, it's Jira to Zendesk, but it could also be only one way from Zendesk to Jira. So it's very easy to use. You just select the field, the direction, and then you have other options here, like if there's no matching value, you can do either report an error or set a default value. I'm gonna keep it as it is for now. As you see here, we're syncing the issue type to the type in Zendesk, status to status, priority, priority, and so on. I'm going to publish this. Don't forget to wait until it is published, otherwise it could lead to errors. Sometimes people click on publish on the, and then they think it's already done, but you need to wait until it is ready and this message comes in. After that's done, now we can synchronize. So let's get to it. I'm gonna go to the project that I selected for this connection, which is this one. As you see, I have no tickets. So I'm going to create a new ticket and I'm gonna call it Jira ticket going to Zendesk. So I am creating this ticket in the project hosted test, which is the one that I initially selected. The summary is Jira ticket going to Zendesk. Description is, this is a test from Jira. I added a label here that is called sync. And I am going to create this issue. Since I selected automatically, that ticket should be sent automatically to the Zendesk instance. So let's see if that happens. When you open the ticket and if you scroll down and to the right, you will see there's an Exalate button, which if you click on it, you will get the status of the synchronization. And it says connection Jira to Zendesk, status synchronized, which means it is already sent. And then here you have the key of the Zendesk ticket, which is 126. And that is not the key from Jira because each will keep the order of the index that they were having before. So the Jira ticket key is JT154 and the Zendesk key is 126. If you want to sync that to a custom field, that's what usually people do in case you want the key from the other end, that's also possible. If you click here, you can jump directly to the ticket if you have credentials on both ends. And that's the case here, so I'm going to open the ticket in Zendesk next to the Jira ticket to make sure that all the data is synced as I want it. And here's the Zendesk ticket. As you see here in the tag section, we have sync, which was the label that we added from Jira. If you look at the title, I cannot look at it right now. Let me zoom out a bit. And here's the title. So it says Jira ticket going to Zendesk. It's the same one that I made from Jira. There's also the description synced as a comment because in Zendesk you don't have a description section. It's always like title and comments. So that's why it's synced as a comment. And now just so you see the bidirectionality, I'm going to create a comment in Zendesk. I'll call it Zendesk comment. And now if you check on the top right apps, you also have the status in Zendesk. it says it is in progress, and then soon the comments should show up here on the Jira side. And there it is. So as you see, the comment is here. It says Zendesk comment. The same would happen the other way around if I make a change on any of the fields that I have here or create a new comment. So this is bidirectionally in all fields you want, as long as you're in the visual mode or a scripted version. The scripted version is, as I mentioned, more configurable. So if you want to do like a small tweaks, like only sync if the comment has this specific word, that's possible with the scripted version. There are a lot of helper methods. And this is just a basic scenario. There are many companies that are doing this with a lot of complex workflows. So if you're interested in learning more about this, feel free to reach out to us, book a demo. We can show you how to integrate the solutions that you have, relating it specifically to the products you have and the workflow you want. I hope this video helped you. And as I mentioned, reach out if needed and see you in another video. Have a good one. Bye-bye.